welcome you guys to my floor. I'm actually doing an inventory of my art supplies. You know, we're coming to the close of spring semester 2013. It's actually my first spring at Academy of Art. I don't know how excited I am. I don't know if I'm more excited about going to the expo or if I'm excited about being extremely close to moving there. I'm literally packing up things and I'm just looking for the right place, so definitely keep wishing me luck. I got kind of a few things to talk about today. This video is going to be very short, but we're going to be talking about my recent discovery with my poor little sunflowers. Now, as many of you know, I've been growing sunflowers for quite some time now, and they were doing so well, and I don't know what happened, but, well, I have a hypothesis of what happened, but basically, I was checking them out today, and I realized how easily they were pulling up out of the soil, and I said, you know what, they were getting so big that their weight just kind of kept pulling them farther and farther out of the soil. I tried to use some type of bamboo type stick to hold them up straight and all that kind of stuff, but it really didn't matter. I think I should have paid more attention to how deep they were buried, and I probably should have supported them a little bit better as they got older and spread them apart or whatever. So what I did as I actually used the leaves and I made a sunflower chip. It was like the coolest thing ever. I'm like so excited to be growing my foods. Shout out to growingyourgreens.com. I watch your videos all the time and you know, I really, really appreciate all the knowledge you share. So I'm gonna share some knowledge. I basically love sunflowers. They're the easiest thing to grow. They start sprouting within about 3 to 4 days, and in about 5, 6, 7 days, you can have a fresh sunflower salad, and it's so good because it's what they call a microgreen. And a microgreen is basically like the small sprouts before it actually turns into like a sustaining growing plant. Because what I learned is that the seed has more than enough nutrients for the plant to grow as a microgreen, and then once the seed gets all the nutrients out of that, it's going to reach for a soil. So when you grow things hydroponically, meaning in water, you don't even need soil because the nutrients are coming from the seed. And I have so many seeds here, all kinds of packages of seeds. Here are my 5 papaya dwarf tree seeds that I got from this really cool eBay store. These get to about 3 to 5 feet in just under a year and start producing fruits at just a foot above the base or the root, which is awesome. So more about these sunflowers. I'm going to wrap up the sunflower topic. But basically, I took some of the leaves and I put them in the stove after I put some olive oil on them and a little bit of salt. I was like, you know, I could put pepper on it too. But according to how you make kale chips, you would basically do the same thing, and I think there's more than one way to prepare it, but the way that I just did it, it was like 10, 15 minutes maybe max, about 250, 300 degrees, and it was so freaking good. And the cool thing about sunflowers is if you love the taste of sunflower seeds, you would love these sunflower microgreens, and you would love the sunflower leaves. You can put them in salads, you can put them in, you know, whatever you want. I'm going to use them mostly for salads. I'm actually going to order about 200 seeds, which will give me probably about between 400, no, yeah, 200 seeds will give me about 400 to 800 leaves to put in a salad. It's a lot of salad. But I'm thinking, what if I tried to make this like the stock of the plant too? Obviously, the water is going to evaporate. It's probably going to be greeny. But I just wonder what that's going to taste like. And I mean, it can't be too bad for you. It's not like a weed or anything like that. It's actually, you can probably eat the whole thing if you wanted to and be totally fine. But don't quote me on that. I'm just going to taste it and see what the hell it tastes like. So, talking about school and my supplies here. I've got everything from my drafting. I've got some basswood, I've got some paint, some India ink, I've got some resources and some drawing tablets. I have tons and tons of sticky, of course, orange because it's the color. We've got our orange tape and black tape and even the skinnier 16th tape. We've got some freaking Primo clay, which hopefully I'll use that soon for some architectural models. What else? I got like a big giant 4-foot roll of craft paper. I've got this trace paper, and behind me I have my like survival bag that I use when I go camping, hiking. Underneath that, I'm going to be doing a review of my overboard waterproof class 3 bag. I'm going to be talking about my computer that I built, my Z77, which I'm currently using. It's a quad core Intel i5 quad overclocked to 3.6 gigahertz from 3.2, which is quite good. And even farther behind this, we've got my climbing box. I'm going to show you guys all that stuff. And like I said, I'm going to get my mind, body, and spirit all together. It's just been kind of a rough semester for a lot of us. A lot of us have gone through personal issues, family issues, you know, educational issues, changing of school, starting school, graduating school, whatever the case may be. It's always good to refresh and recharge the batteries. Excuse the landscape people. They want to keep our apartments nice and beautiful. It's nice and beautiful. So I'm going to be talking a lot about feng shui, a lot about mind, body, spirit, environment. Because it's very important to keep all those things in balance. I even keep my body balanced with my mind, body, and spirit. But also, body-wise, I've got like natural materials like leather here on the side, and I've got metals on this side. And, you know, that's just kind of, you know, one of my little philosophies, and, you know, I'll pretty much entertain you guys on that stuff a little bit later. I'm just chilling right now. I just had to record this video because I was thinking to myself, you know, my sunflowers are basically dying now. I might as well just make a whole bunch of sunflower chips, really go the whole nine and actually make chips out of them, see what I can use the parts for. I'm going to be moving the quad over near my flat screen in the living room area so I can have a better set. I'm going to keep this area my inventory area for now. You'll probably get to see my really beautiful octagonal table that the computer's on. I'm going to be cleaning my room. I'm going to be doing showers. And anyway, these guys are kind of like playing with my environment, so I'm going to go ahead and change my environment so I can keep my mind good and healthy. And I'll talk to you guys a little bit later, but hope everybody's doing good. Shout out to all my good friends, Leilani, Jim, you know, Amy, shout out to you. Shout out to my new friend, Laura. Shout out to Claudia, shout out to Katak, and Kelsey, and there's so many people. I'm literally going to have to meet every single one of you guys, you know that, right, when I get there. So anyway, hope you guys are having a good day, and see you guys next time. Phil Bailey, signing out. Subscribe, follow, whatever, holler. Yeah, that's what I said.